first stage would be the material coming in interchangeably, we'll say cigarette butts or cigarette filters. And we're able to recycle it as a plastic material. My name is Ernel Simpson. I'm from Jamaica originally. I'm the Executive Vice President of R&D and Technology Innovation for TerraCycle. I've been working in the area of science for about 50 years. In 2011, we started looking at how to recycle cigarette filters. People simply throw the cigarette filters, particularly in waterways. It's not a material that's gonna decompose. It was looked at as a nuisance waste. Nicotine is one problem, but there are something called phenols in tobacco. We started looking at this and we were able to reduce the amount of nicotine and the phenols and tar by doing a lot of extraction and also blending different plastic into different alloys. 90% of the plastic industry is sold in this form. Once the cigarette butts come to TerraCycle, right, they're stored. We wait until we have, you know, at least a truckload of material, which is about 40,000 pounds. They'll weigh the material, they'll look at how clean it is, and then it moves to the processing. After you process the material, we have used it to make lumber made from combination of this powder with other materials as well. We have used the material to make shipping pallets. We have made ashtrays and tables and benches and things like that.
You know, we're veering in on a billion butts soon.
Yeah.
With TerraCycle, we've been able to launch national cigarette recycling solutions, not just in the United States, but all over the world. You can access that completely for free. We cover the cost of you shipping the waste to us and recycling all the material. All right, Ernie, thank you, as always, sir. If you're interested in how to recycle things that you couldn't before, ranging from cigarette butts to writing instruments, from cosmetics and all sorts of different things, you can find all that and more at TerraCycle.com.